Thank you, Holy Spirit. And I pray that God Almighty will continue to bless us in the mighty name of Jesus. Yeah, let's go to the business of today. And I will be picking the text of this message from the book of Ephesians, chapter 1, verse 17, which happened to do with the prayer of Paul to the church of Ephesians. And he said, he prayed that the eyes of your understanding be enlightened. That is a prayer for the spirit of wisdom and revelation to rest upon the church of Ephesians. And the purpose of that spirit of wisdom and revelation is so that the eyes of their understanding be enlightened. And the purpose why he wants the eyes of their understanding to be enlightened is so that they can know what they need to know and do what they need to do. I repeat. The purpose why God wants the eyes of the understanding to be enlightened is so that they can know what they need to know and also do what they need to do. And to every season of life, the reason why many believers are confused and frustrated in their journey of life is simply because they journey through a path whereby they don't know what they need to know, and because of that, they cannot do what they need to do. Maleko tole moshanda lekato. And many people have been struggling to know the difference between wisdom and revelation. And the question I just want to throw to you and also do justice to now is, what is the difference between wisdom and revelation? Wisdom is the key to material blessing, while revelation is the key to spiritual blessing. You can write. I repeat. Wisdom is the key to material blessing, while revelation is the key to spiritual blessing. That is, if God wants you to be rich in grace, he blesses you with revelation. And if he wants you to be rich in grace, he blesses you with wisdom. I repeat. If God wants you to be rich in grace, he blesses you with revelation. And if he wants you to be rich in grace, that is, if he wants you to be rich in material blessing, he blesses you with wisdom. That is, if God wants you to be rich in God, he blesses you with revelation. And if he wants you to be rich in gold, he blesses you with wisdom. You cannot separate material blessing from wisdom. And you cannot separate spiritual blessing from revelation. The Bible says faith is the mystery behind grace. That is, grace is obtained by faith. And faith is when you respond to revelational knowledge of a certain reality pertaining to the person of Christ and what Christ has done for you. I repeat. Faith is response to revelational knowledge pertaining to what Christ has done, who Christ is to you, and what he has done for you. So you must have the understanding of the difference between wisdom and revelation. I repeat, and I say this again, you can never separate wisdom from material blessing, and you cannot separate wisdom from spiritual blessing. The Bible said in the book of 2 Peter chapter 1 verses 2, it said God has given us everything pertaining to life and godliness, and they begin to give us the pattern through which we enter into the economy of things pertaining to life and godliness. It has said through the knowledge of God. Through the knowledge of God. So when it comes to the knowledge of God, it is by revelation. Well, when it comes to the knowledge of the things of God, it is by wisdom. There are differences between the knowledge of the person of God and the knowledge of the things of God. I repeat, there are differences between the knowledge of the person of God and the knowledge of the things of God. So by revelation, you enter into the economy of the revelation of the knowledge of the person of God, while by wisdom, you enter into the economy of the knowledge of the things of God. And then I said, things pertaining to life and godliness has been given to us. Pertaining to life, material blessing, godliness, spiritual blessing. So when you set all you want to pursue, there are things pertaining to godliness, you will truly make heaven. But I use this opportunity to tell you that you may likely become earthly irrelevant. And if you also want to say the only thing you want to pursue are things pertaining to life, I use this opportunity to tell you that you will surely make this edge, but if care is not taken, you will lose your eternity. So, but the balancing aspect of it is that when Christ came, he gave us things pertaining to life, he also gave us things pertaining to godliness.
Ah, my kontoli moshandalaga.
So, when it comes to the knowledge of the person of God, it is by revelation. And when it comes to the knowledge of the things of God, it is by wisdom. The things of God have to do with the material thing that God, the natural thing that God has created on this earth. An ability to have the wisdom of how to use the natural thing that God has created will bring you into the economy of material sources. It is by wisdom we discover that there are kuroyet in the soil. It is by the wisdom we discover that there are gold in the soil, that if that gold can be processed, it will bring us a value and bring us into the economy of a certain material blessing. It is by wisdom we know the value of tree. It is by wisdom we know the value of what things, the natural thing that God has created on this mortal earth. Because every natural thing that God created, he created them for our advantage. And if we suffer them, it is simply because the wisdom of God is missing in our life to discover the treasure that God has deposited into his most natural thing. So, there is a treasure that God deposited in the natural things that he created on earth. There's also a wisdom that God, there's also a treasure that God deposited in Christ for our spiritual advantage. So we have things that God deposited for our natural advantage, and we also have things that God deposited for our spiritual advantage. So the things that God deposited for our natural advantage, they are on earth. That is why you don't need to be born again to be materially rich, because everything pertaining to your life has been placed upon the earth. But things pertaining to your godliness, things pertaining to your spiritual blessing, they are not on earth. They are where? In Christ. Because Ephesians chapter 1 verse 16 says, God has blessed us with every spiritual blessing. And he now said that spiritual blessing is in heavenly places. And he now said the heavenly places is in Christ Jesus.
Ephesians 1:3.
That he has blessed us with every spiritual blessing. He didn't say he has blessed us with every material blessing. Every material blessing is not in Christ. Every material blessing is on earth. I repeat. Every material blessing is not in Christ. Every material blessing is on earth. And it is by the wisdom of God that he used to enter into the economy of how to tap into the reality of the things that is on earth and use it for your own advantage and for your own success. But when it comes to the things pertaining to godliness, when it comes to the things pertaining to spiritual blessing, they are not on earth, they are in Christ. So you need to be born again to enter into the economy of spiritual blessing, while you need to be born on earth to enter into the economy of material blessing. By wisdom, you enter into the economy of material blessing, while by revelation, you enter into the economy of spiritual blessing. I think you can see the difference between wisdom and revelation. And the purpose of wisdom is now, because now let me say this, because we have two dimensions of wisdom. We have natural wisdom and we have the wisdom of God. Because there are certain dimensions of wisdom that you can never have until you give your life to Jesus. But there are certain dimensions of wisdom you can have even though you don't give your life to Jesus. We call those dimensions of wisdom common sense. We call them natural wisdom. But there is certain dimension of wisdom that you can never have until you encounter Christ. And that dimension of wisdom is what Paul was praying for in the book of Ephesians. He called it spirit of wisdom. Spirit of wisdom. This kind of wisdom is not the one you discover by studying. It is the one you receive by prayer. He said in the book of Ephesians, is it book of James, he said, if anyone lack wisdom, let him pray. He didn't say, if anyone lack wisdom, let him study. There is a dimension of wisdom you encounter by study. Why there is a dimension of wisdom you encounter by prayer.
You receive it by prayer. So this dimension of wisdom that you receive by prayer is called the spirit of wisdom. And the purpose of that spirit is so that you can begin to use the spiritual resources to solve natural problems. By revelation, you use spiritual power, spiritual resources to solve spiritual problems. Why by wisdom of God, you use spiritual resources to solve natural problems? There are certain natural problems on earth that it takes the wisdom of God to enter into the economy and use that wisdom of God to solve that natural problem. That a problem is natural doesn't mean you can use natural means to solve it.
I repeat,
not all natural problems you can use natural means to solve. I repeat, not all natural problem you can use natural means to solve. There are certain natural problems that you need divine wisdom to enter into the economy of grace and bring out the certain supernatural idea to solve that natural problem. Get this and get this right. We have two dimensions of problem. And we have two dimensions of way of solving it. We have spiritual problem, we should use spiritual means to solve it. It is foolishness to be using natural means to solve spiritual problem. That is foolishness. But it is wisdom to be using spiritual means to solve natural problems. This is the kind of wisdom that the children of darkness understand. That Jesus of Christ, Jesus was trying to say that the children of darkness are more wiser than the children of light. Because most of these children of darkness, you see, they understand how to use the principle of darkness. They understand how to use the wisdom of darkness to solve a natural problem. They will have a company. Design the company. Advertise the company. Use different kind of modern technology in the company, but they won't stop there. They will also have relationship with the darkness to back up the company. So they don't only rely on business strategies. They don't only rely on 7 steps to grow your business. They did not only rely on 7 mechanisms of growing your business that many of us are building our Christian faith on in the Christian, in the body of Christ. As good as that dimension may be, it's not only the pattern through which you move on this certain earth. We must understand how to use spiritual forces to move the things pertaining to natural.
Tell somebody beside you. Enter into the economy of the spirit of wisdom and revelation. Now let me give you some certain definition of the difference between wisdom and revelation I wrote down here. Wisdom is when you know what you need to know and what you need to do in order to live in the physical realm. I repeat, wisdom is when you need to know, when you know what you need to know and what you need to do in order to live in the physical realm. Where revelation helps you to know what you need to know and what you need to do in order to live in the spiritual realm. I repeat. Wisdom helps you to know what you need to know and what you need to do in order to live in the natural realm. Where revelation helps you to know what you need to know and what you need to do in order to live in the spiritual realm. Because man is ordained to live in 2 realms. There's aspect of you that live in the realm of the spirit, and there's an aspect of you that live in the natural realm. And the aspect of you that live in the natural realm can never survive until you tap into the economy of wisdom. Why the aspect of you that live in the realm of the spirit, which is the spiritual life, can never grow into maturity, into stature, until you enter into the economy of revelation. So you must understand the action of revelation and the action of grace. Both of them have to do with something you need to know and something you need to do. Wisdom has to do with something you need to know and something you need to do in the physically. Why? Revelation has to do with something you need to know and something you need to do spiritually. So both of them, there is an action word pertaining to the two. So when it comes to the corner of both wisdom and revelation, you are not to fold your arm. There is an action statement. There is an action step. There is an action decision that pertains to that realm. And that is what you need to understand now. That's where we are stopping now. The understanding the action of wisdom and the understanding the action of revelation. The action of wisdom and revelation. The action of wisdom and revelation. Pay attention now. The action of wisdom is more of what you need to do. I repeat. The action of wisdom is more of what you need to do.
Why the action of revelation is more of what you need to deny.
I repeat,
the action of wisdom is more of what you need to do. That is a step you need to take. Why the action of wisdom, the action of revelation is not about a step you need to take. It is about things you need to deny. When it comes to the realm of the spirit, you don't do anything. It is all about what Christ has done. When it comes to the physical realm, when it comes to the material thing, you don't just open or hope in faith. You have to do something. This is where religious people got it wrong. Pay attention diligently now to this balancing of this message. When it comes to spiritual things, you don't do anything. You deny everything. When it comes to material things, you don't deny, you do. You don't just fold your hands and pray when it comes to things pertaining to this earth. There are some certain action and step you need to take if you want things to work for you materially.
I repeat, the action of wisdom, as I said earlier, the action of wisdom is more of what you need to do.
While the action of revelation is more of what you need to deny. The purpose of the denying is so that what Christ has done will find expression in your life. The purpose of denying is not so that you can receive. By faith you receive. The purpose of sacrifice in the kingdom is not so that you can get anything from God. Everything has been given based on the sacrifice of Christ. But in order for you to enter into the economy of manifestation, you need to deny some certain thing. And there are two things you need to deny. Pay attention now. Because many people are acting religiously, but they are not acting spiritually. There are two things basically you need to deny when it comes to things pertaining to the things of the spirit. One, you need to deny things that is taking away your time. Two, you need to deny things that is taking away your heart. Things that is making you to enter into the economy of divided attention, you need to deny yourself from them. Because when your heart is not single, your body can never be full of light. It is when your heart is single that your body can be full of light. So when your heart is not single, automatically your body will be full of darkness. And when your body is full of darkness, you enter into the economy of confusion. You enter into the economy of frustration. So two things you need to deny. One, things that is taking away your heart. Two, things that is taking away your time. Things that is not making you to pay much attention in this with the fellowship of the spirit. Things that is not making you to pay attention in the secret place. Some people will say, oh, I need to fast and pray. Get this, relax your mind. Get out of all this religious mentality. The purpose of fasting is so that you can be concentrated. Go to the Old Testament and understand the purpose of fasting. The purpose of fasting is not so that you can deny the body. Denying of your body from food is not spirituality, it is religiosity.
I repeat,
denying this physical body from food because God created the body to eat. So denying the body from food and claim you are fasting is not spirituality. That is religiosity. Because the purpose of fasting food is not so that you can suffer the body. The purpose of fasting food is so that you can be concentrated and you can be connected. It is so that your body will not be, your mind will not be divided. You remember the story of the reality of Sabbath in the Old Testament where God asked them not to work, not to eat, so that they would just stay. And that is just the mystery or the summary of what fasting is all about. They don't work, they don't go to places, they stay in one place and fellowship. What God really wants to achieve is undivided attention. He wants to free them from things taking away their time and things taking away their heart. If you can understand how to deny things taking away your heart and things taking away your time, you have entered into the economy of the true fasting of the New Testament. So when the Bible said, this goeth not out except by fasting and prayer, even though we have many theological factors around that Bible verse, but nevertheless, if you still want to hold on to that Bible verse, that Jesus said, this goeth not out except by fasting and prayer, I'm using this opportunity to tell you that fasting is not about fasting food, it's about fasting things that is taking away your time and fasting things taking away your heart from God. So Jesus did not say this goeth not out except by fasting food. Fasting means things, denying yourself from things that is taking away your heart and things that is taking away your time from God. Because the two things that God needs, your time and your heart. Your time and your heart. So when it comes to revelation, it has to do with something you need to deny. But when it comes to wisdom, it has to do with something you need to do. And those things you need to do, they are governing principles, they are governing laws. If you don't understand those laws, those principles, those keys, you enter into the economy of how to use the things that God has created in this natural realm, how to use the natural law, how to use the spiritual law to enter into the economy of what you need in life. Can you understand the two now? When it comes to wisdom, it is about the principles you need to apply. When it comes to revelation, it is about the things you need to deny. If you can understand these two, your life will never remain the same. When it comes to the things pertaining to the spirit, when it comes to the things pertaining to this earth, because according to the plan of God, He wants you to be blessed in all areas of life, both spiritually and both materially. If you are blessed spiritually and you are not blessed materially, you are not fully blessed. Your joy can never be full. And if you are blessed spiritually, materially, and you are not blessed spiritually, is a calamity that is about to happen. But when you are blessed spiritually and you are blessed materially, you enter into the economy of the fullness of joy that God has really paid and given you as a gift. God will bless you in the mighty name of Jesus.